Today, we're talking Davinci. No, not that one. Davinci Resolve, the video editing software. With over 2 million users worldwide, Davinci Resolve is truly leading the way when it comes to video editing software. If you're one of those 2 million users, why not increase your working speed by 5,335,672%? More or less. Allowing more time for professional projects or even your passion projects. Hi Digmates, I'm sci-fi movie buff Dominique Garcia. And before we go any further, if you like our content, please let us know by clicking that subscribe button. For each new subscriber, I get given 20 cents. And I'm kinda saving up for a mighty lunch. Now, down to the goods. Whether you use DaVinci for pleasure or profession, editing videos can sometimes be a painstaking process. And I think we can all agree that saving time while working more efficiently is the ultimate goal, right? This might lead you to purchase a keyboard or a control panel designed specifically for DaVinci Resolve editing, which is completely understandable. There are some hefty advantages to these devices, making lighter work of those video edits, while also making you feel as if you're flying some sort of spaceship.
Strap yourselves in, I'm gonna make a jump to light speed.
But these often very expensive control panels have their fair share of disadvantages too. They can be clunky, complicated, unergonomic, and oftentimes limited to DaVinci only. I mean, what if you like to take mini breaks during video edits to reply to emails, surf the web, or catch up on some casual Dota? This then leaves the option of using just a regular keyboard to edit your videos. But with all of those commands, which often vary from program to program, along with a dire need for more shortcuts, using a regular keyboard can feel like a bit of a drag. What if I told you there was a third option and a surefire way to maximize your DaVinci working speed by using a regular keyboard? Of course, this is our segue to introduce the Dygma Raise or the Dygma Defy as an option. But as a matter of fact, any programmable keyboard will probably do the trick. The secret to that increased productivity is in the layers. Programmable keyboards come with the ability to add numerous layers that can be switched at the tap of a key. Essentially, the ability to build your own DaVinci Resolve control panel. Aside from having your own DaVinci control panel, up to 10 layers can be programmed into your Raise or Defy, complete with LEDs under each key for easy classification. To show some DaVinci-based layers in action, we're going to introduce you to the man behind the magic here at Dygma Studios, David Moreno, otherwise known in English as David Tand. Hello, Mr. Tand! So, you're the man behind the video editing here at Dygma Studios. Is there anything else that you do?
Well, actually, I answer messages from you, from Slack, to tell you to stop bothering me.
Okay, and how much more efficient is it to use layers when editing?
I haven't timed it yet, but I know that after using the Raise, doing these shortcuts on a regular keyboard, like this 100% keyboard, is not as ergonomic or efficient.
So, do you have any idea how much time you save when you use the Dygma Raise?
No.
Well, later we'll show a side-by-side comparison to get a better understanding of this. And don't worry, if you'd like to save the layers shown in this video, we'll provide the downloadable link in the description below.
Well, now we are in the editing room of Dygma Studios. We are going to switch from a regular typing layer to the DaVinci layers. Now we can remove the right half of my Dygma Raise because we won't be needing this while editing in DaVinci. Having it this way means that I've maximized this side and programmed the keys to have all the functions I need for editing. This way, my left hand is on the keyboard and my right hand is in the mouse. I no longer need to switch from mouse to the keyboard, mouse to the keyboard. As you can see, I've color coded each key for function recognition and for more ease when explaining this DaVinci layer to you. You'll first see that the purple keys have the same functions as on a regular keyboard: escape key, tab, and command. This is because I'm used to do a lot of command tab to change between programs. I have other navigation keys such as the 5 and 6 in pink to change between desktops, left and right. Whoops. Now let's dive deep into the main editing features of my DaVinci layers. For these green keys, I've moved the N and the Command M, which are found on the right side of the keyboard, to here. They allow me to easily access the magnet and the link functions. For example, the magnet allows you to be more precise when you are, you know, trimming or you have some clips to attach, and if you hide it, now you are like free, but it's more unprecise. In the other side, the link allows you to link or unlink the video track from the audio track. Starting at the very bottom of my keyboard with the under row thumb keys, the right under row thumb key allows me to easily zoom in and zoom out while using the wheel of my mouse, while the left under row thumb key allows me to easily scroll from left to right. Above these keys, usually where the standard spacebar would be, I have the Command B and the Command Z. Nice and simple, these keys allows me to cut Command B and under the editing with the Command Z. Above them, I have the Command Z to copy and the Command B to paste. Standard, basic business. Next to it, I have the Alt B to paste the clip attributes to another clip. For example, this clip is unedited and I want to paste from this clip a color gradient. Then I will press the Command C to copy, and then I will press this key to paste attributes. Corrección cromática, in Spanish, color grading, and I will go to this key, that is the Enter, where the usual shift would be, to select my settings. Then, moving on up, we have the F, the D, and the A keys. They are in the same position as a regular keyboard because I was already used to them. The F key takes me to the original RAW file. The D mutes a clip once it's selected, mute and unmute, and the A key is the regular selection tool. Above these keys, near the top of my Dygma Raise, I have the T, which is my trimming T. If I ever fancy a little trim, I tap this. I usually change a lot between this selection tool with the A and this trimming tool. Then I have the Command R key, which gives me the speed selection of the clips being edited. Finally, I have in the 4 the R key, which allows me to change the speed or invert a clip with this little handy pop-up. Then I move the I and the O keys here, color them white. For example, if I'm in the media pool and I want to select a clip to put in the video, I select the input, I select the output, and then I can drag this into the timeline. Then, the lone dark blue key in the center of my keyboard is the delete key. This can delete clips, this, or delete empty space, like this. Last but not least, I have here the shift key, where the 3 is. This allows me to select everything in the timeline. I've fully utilized the majority of the keys, enabling me to work without my hand ever leaving my keyboard. My goal for the future is to move the alpha keys of the right side here to the left, so I can eventually type just by using the left half of the keyboard. The same way as I do with this layer to use the arrows, or even the media keys.
This is great, but do you really save much time working with this DaVinci focused layer?
Let's find out.
We've given David two small editing tasks. He will have to trim two different clips of the same duration. This is a controlled environment, and David is a trained professional. But feel free to try this at home.
Okay, let's go.
This was a small task, but David saved 5 minutes using the Raise. That's 44%. Granted, David has been using the Raise for more than a year, so he's already quite efficient. But just do the math. That's around 25 minutes saved every hour, and over 3 hours saved every standard working day. That works out to 60 hours a month, which is an extra week and a half gained every single month. What can you do with that extra time? What can you earn with that extra time? At Dygma, we're focused primarily on ergonomics, but increased functional ergonomics is also possible with these kinds of tricks and hacks. And a programmable keyboard isn't just for increasing efficiency on DaVinci Resolve. With up to 10 programmable layers, you can build your own personal control panel for the programs that you use the most, allowing your keyboard to be an all-in-one setup that doesn't require you to adapt to it, but instead gives you the power to make it adapt to you. This is now our second video in which we've dived into the possible layers of a well-known program. Which program do you think we should cover next? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and in the wise words of Obi-Wan Kenobi, to infinity and beyond!